Yeah, I'm Dave Gilson. I'm in the support group, and I've been supporting SQL products for almost 25 years. And I just want to take a few minutes here to show you a little bit about the Excel add-in component in Viewpoint. Right now, you have several ways of getting results to Excel. You can simply save the results to a PC file and then access that file. You do have the option from a display to export the data to Excel, kind of like a screen scrape. And you also have an option on a view to simply click on it and say open in Excel. They all have their advantages and uses, but they also share one limitation, and that's that each one of them is only dealing with one data set at a time. And maybe that's sufficient for some things, but maybe it'd be nice to have more than one set of data on one Excel spreadsheet to be able to compare data. So what exactly is the add-in? It's basically a tool that provides a link from your spreadsheet to your Viewpoint views. So instead of pushing the information out, you're in the Excel spreadsheet and you're pulling data in. It gives you a little more flexibility as far as what columns you want to use from your views. So if you have quite a busy view and you just don't want to see all the columns, you can pick and choose. It also enables you to combine multiple views in the spreadsheet. So you could do data comparison, store to store, warehouse to warehouse. And while you're in the spreadsheet, you can refresh data at any time. So you're not working with static data. So the next question might be, how or where do I get this add-in? You may already have it installed, it's hard to say, but the add-in is installed or it's available through the Viewpoint install process. And one of the initial windows you get is whether you want to do a standard install or a custom install. And if you choose custom, you'll see the three components that are available to install, and the Excel add-in is one of them. So you want to make sure you check that. And once the install is done, how will you know if you have this add-in there? It shows up in Excel. So the next time you'll put an Excel spreadsheet, you should see a Viewpoint option on the home bar after the help. So I want to take just a couple minutes to actually show you this so you can see the mechanics and see what it can look like. So I first want to create a new spreadsheet to see the basic mechanics and how easy it is. And then I'm going to open up an existing spreadsheet that's got a little bit more formatting done ahead of time.
Dave, we can see your screen.
Okay, good. All right, so here I just got a brand new spreadsheet that I've opened. And I see at the top here next to the help, there is now a Viewpoint option that tells me the add-in is there. When I click on that, I will get some extra options over here. And the first one is to add a view. So wherever my cursor is positioned, here's where the view is going to get added to. So I'm going to go through this process real quick. Take a minute while it connects. Okay, so I've got my system identified. I want to point it to the given library that I want to look into. Click on the browse button to get a list of views. I'll just take the first one here. And I have a couple options here as far as whether I want to include column headings or not. Maybe I've already got my headings formatted in the Excel spreadsheet and I just want to bring in data. And I also have a choice here for what columns I want to pick from the view. So if there's a couple I don't want to see, just a matter of clicking on it and removing it from the list. I'm going to keep them all. And in it comes. So I could do multiples of these depending on what positions and what room I need. But one thing I want to point out here is, and if you do this right now with the one at a time, columns aren't always formatted the way you want to see them, and they're not always wide enough to see all the data. So every time you do this on the one at a time basis, you've got to kind of reformat things. The nice thing with this add-in is you can go in there and you can modify your columns to look just like you want. And the next time you open it up and refresh data, the data will fit right in there. All the formatting is done for you. So that's simple enough. Let's look at an existing one that has a little bit more formatting done and actually has some prompting going on as well. Okay, so look in the background, you can see that I've got little bits of data here that are comparing products and warehouses information. And the first thing here is asking me, do you want to refresh the data for this? So right now you can see by the labels in there that this is November data. Yeah, I would like to refresh the data as I go in here. These views all prompt for the same thing, a month. And if I name the variable the same in all the views, I'll only get prompted one time in here and it will refresh all the views. In this case, with October data. So you have a lot of flexibility in here, and you can, like I said, I've already put in some of my hard-coded labels here, column headings along with it. And while I'm in here, if I want to switch it around and I want to get some new data, I have an option here for refreshing. And you can refresh all the views or just a particular view. I'm going to refresh them all. I should get prompted again. Let's go for a different month here. So you have an awful lot of flexibility in what you see, and you also are able to use this for a comparison basis. So instead of having a huge list of detail and scrolling down, I can summarize these information for a given warehouse or a given store ID or whatever, and be able to compare the stuff side by side. So that's really it. It's very quite simple. So that's the basic information for the Excel add-in component in Viewpoint. Thank you.